Yo guys, welcome to RenderRam, my name is Vieco, and today I'm gonna cover this new plugin that's been circulating the internet for a couple of days now from recording of this video, and it's called UVReactor. So UVReactor is this new unwrapping plugin. So, but why is this unwrapping plugin so cool compared to everything else that's offered on the market? Well, it's the fastest in the world. And I'm not talking a little bit faster, I'm talking like 10 to 50 times faster. Faster than, I don't know, Houdini's Unwrap, Modo, Rhizom UV, you name it. This thing is blazing fast. So when you go to RapidMXS.com webpage, you can download the beta here. The beta was released a couple of days ago. It's still buggy, but of course, join the Discord. You have the link here and you can report any bugs, request features or whatever. Anyhow, let me show you what's it all about. So I have this scene, and this is this very nice plant that I'm gonna be using as my unwrapping victim for today. And this plant is, of course, from Evermotion. Evermotion released their Arc Models Volume 268, and this is the latest plant package, and all these plants are super high quality, really, really cool models. I'm also gonna leave the links for these cool plants in the description if you wanna check them out. What is so cool about UVReactor? UVReactor, for a start, is not a modifier. It's not like you finish your object and then you just toss unwrap modifier on top or UVW map modifier on top. It's not a modifier. It's a viewport. So what do I mean by that? So look at this. When you install it, you have the UVReactor here. You click on open UVReactor and you get this. First thing that's really cool is anything that you select, you're instantly going to see the UV info. So you can see, I mean, look at the mesh of this plant. It's not like a low poly mesh, to be honest, but when you just click it, it gets here. When you start creating any object, it's going to appear here. When I create a teapot, it's there. So anything that I select, it will instantly be shown here. If I select all three of them, I'm going to see all of my UVs from all the selected objects. Now that's a really, really cool feature. But the best thing about it is when you click it, and I'm in my editable poly mode, just to say one thing, because it's beta, it currently supports only editable poly. So whatever you do, you must be in editable poly. You cannot have any modifier. I mean, you can have modifiers stacked on top of your object and UVReactor will see those effects and everything, but you cannot modify your UVs. So for now, for this stage of development, you need to have exclusively editable poly to have the option to manipulate your UVs. Support for everything else will come shortly. So let me just first give you a quick overview of UVReactor. So here you have your main viewport. You zoom in, zoom out by long pressing right click, and with the middle mouse button you just pan around, right? On the right you have all the unwrapping features. Of course, tons of these features will be added in the near future, so stick around for any new updates. Now, first thing that you can kind of notice to be very similar to your daily workflow are these buttons here. So whenever I, for example, click here, you can also notice that polygon mode got activated in my editable poly. If I click on like edge mode, it's going to be here. If I click here in the editable poly, it's going to be here. So this thing is completely 100% connected to the editable poly. Now, the reason why you don't have a modifier here, like an unwrap modifier or something, because every object that you create has some sort of UV data in it. And for you to see it, you need to have a modifier that's going to show that data. But this, like I said before, literally acts like a UV viewport. So you don't need a modifier because UV data is constantly here and this just enables you to see it. But the most fascinating thing about this is it is fast as a viewport. Check this out. If you want to select any selection here, look at this. I'm just going to start dragging. Look at what happens in the viewport. Look how satisfying this is. Look at this. And it's completely reactable. So I'm going to create a teapot. And on that teapot, I'm going to toss Turbo Smooth. You can see how instantly when adding Turbo Smooth, things are updated here. So one iteration, two iterations, three iterations, four iterations. And that's a 1 million polygon object right now that we see here. So when I collapse this and I go to my poly mode, well, look at this. This is a 1 million polygon object. 1 million polys, and if you use shortcuts WER, you can move it freely. Look at this. This is the reaction. So this thing is practically real time, and you are adjusting your UVs in real time. So whenever I need to unwrap a high poly object, that's usually a nightmare because everything is extremely slow. But this is viewport speed. I've never seen anything like this. Let's go back to our plant. Now, picture this. You have this plant and you have this pot and you're not done with your modeling. Let's say you need to do some engraving on the pot. So when I select it here, I can just instantly go here and just move that selection down here. Now, look at this. If I zoom in and I go to my, let's say, cut tool. So I'm gonna just position here and I need to do this silly engraving. So I'm gonna start cutting from here, here to here. Do you see what's happening? It's creating cuts as I'm cutting. So this, let's say here to here, and I'm gonna end it here. And that's it. Look, I can select that selection in my UV reactor or in my viewport, it doesn't really matter. What is cool about this is, since I'm still in the modeling phase, I know that this will be like my UV island. It will be my UV shell. What I can do is scroll down to UV topology and I can click break. And you can notice that this bright orange outline happened. Now I can zoom out and just move this on a side. And it's gonna be here. Now check this out. If I wanna, let's say, extrude this object. Now, because I extruded this whole thing, it got kind of connected again. So it's not a separate island again. So I'm just gonna go to my UV topology and click break. So now this is a separate thing. Now the next thing we need to do is we need to flatten this whole thing because this is a useless information. So under the flatten, you have initial circle, initial square, flatten, planar, straighten. So initial circle and initial square are these two new things, at least for me, they are pretty new features. So whenever I would do like an unfold mapping or unfold flattening, I would always notice when that process happens, you know, when I have my UV mesh, when I'm about to flatten it, when I click the button, it would always, you know, like this UV island, it would always turn to some spherical element and then it will turn to my flattened desired final effect. So I was kind of curious, why is that? And that is because whenever you activate a flatten, as it is, flatten will always lay out all the polygons so that they are kind of perfectly positioned everywhere. And from that point, it will flatten them. And you can also see those circles always happening in the beginning of your unfold flattening. So to start this whole process, I'm just gonna click on initial circle. It looks like this. And then I'm gonna click flatten. So if you check here, yeah, this is now completely unwrapped. But there is only one difference. This hole is this big and this whole thing is massive. So how do you kind of adjust the size of these two? Well, you have the section that's called texel density. So texel density, from here you can basically rescale things to be in the proper scale. So how do you kind of approach it? You select one polygon, let's say this one here. You click get texel density. So this is the texel density of this polygon. And when you click on here, let's say, and click get texel density, you're gonna see a different number. This number has to be the same as this one. So get texel density, you select this whole UV island and you just click set texel density. And now you have the correct scale size. So it's pretty straightforward. You know, like if you want to align things differently, let's say I'm going to loop this selection and I want this whole island to be horizontal. Under align section, you have align shell by edge horizontal. You click that, it's just going to turn it around. It's pretty straightforward. You know, it's very simple. Like if you go up, you have your packings, you can pack everything, you can pick the resolutions, select by various different methods, by materials, seams, angle. You can also, have a backdrop image. You just click on open image, load something in, you can see your image. You have your backdrop opacity. It's pretty easy to kind of manipulate and navigate this whole thing. One thing that was confusing for me when I was comparing it to an actual unwrap, and when you open the unwrap, you kind of see this whole area here, and this is your main UV space, right? Well, that UV space here is literally where you see your backdrop image now. It's this area here. So this is just a grid that's currently placed here. I don't know if this will be changed in the future, but it's just there. So don't let this confuse you. Your whole unwrap area is not this whole thing. It's just this part here. Now I'm just gonna reset my whole scene so that I can show you something else. So if I select this pot, I can just zoom in here, go to move tool and move it down. And if I go to my vertex mode and if I wanna move this down, you will see how the texture stretches and this is fine. And nothing happens here because, I mean, you know what's happening when you're just dragging a bunch of vertexes. But there is a feature in Max, it's here on the right, it's called Preserve UVs. When you click on that, Max will try to understand that you are moving some vertices and it's going to try and fill the space with, you know, a new UV info. So look at this. When you move this down, you can see that nothing gets stretched. But this has its own limitations. You can notice here when I move it down, you can see that funky business is happening here. And the problem with preserved UVs is you never knew exactly what was happening there. You never had an idea why some of these things are stretching. But here now, if you take a look at UVReactor, you can actually see exactly what is happening on the UV level. And you can, you know, kind of understand where the problem is coming from, what is happening with it. So yeah, this literally acts like this cool unwrapping like UV viewport, and I've never seen anything like that. I truly believe that this will be a mandatory technology for anyone who's serious into any form of unwrapping or something, because this, like, what this thing is offering is just mind-bending to me. But not only that, I was messing with this for like the last 2 days, and whatever I was doing, I had a minimum impact in my head that I was unwrapping, you know, that I was doing that boring part, because this literally felt like a part of modeling. Because usually when I model stuff, it's always like, oh, you do modeling and then you do unwrap. But this felt like a part of modeling. So it wasn't, you know, it wasn't the worst experience. It was actually fantastic. Because, you know, like, whichever things you were doing, you constantly had a preview on what is going on. How is your mesh being affected? Not to mention, you learn how Max reacts to different things that you add, and it's just fascinating. Go to the RapidMXS webpage. I'm gonna leave the links down below. Download beta, try it for yourself. Please go to the Discord channel. I'm gonna also leave the link for the Discord channel in my description. Test it out, report bugs, because this could be the ultimate unwrapping experience in this whole industry practically. And the more you contribute by reporting bugs, requesting features, you could have like the best unwrapping program ever. Thank you for watching, and thank you, RenderRam, for sponsoring this video. See you in the next one. Bye.